And as you can see here, Python displays, for instance, struct pack 53 to only a byte 5. It interprets that as a string, which makes it a little bit hard to understand. So what you need to do is, if you want to play with this, is to hexlify the values and well, if you want to see what happens. So for instance, 52 is hexadecimal 34. But in this case, I have a resolution of 255. So now I want to send that. So let's send. And I'll directly can send a value of 52. It should be 1 byte. Yeah, it's 1 byte. And if we look at the TTN console here, I can see that the payload is 34, which, well, it's a bit confusing, but that's the hexadecimal notation for the integer 52, as it is in base 16 instead of base 10. So we need to take care about this. So let's go to payload formats, and I'll make my own custom format. There is a KN low payload package format, which you can import, which is really a neat way of just don't caring about this at all. This is a JavaScript, and I'll define a variable and decoded out, and I'll write bytes 0, and let's see what happens if I just input 34 into this function. I can test it. Out 52. Save payload function. And let's go back to data. And I'll send the same again, 52. And now you can see that I have a new payload 34, out 52. So now this actually gives an output. I never were able, if I weren't going to do this payload format function, I would never get an output into whatever I want an output to. So this is how easy it is to take care of about this. If I want to do something with this data, let's say I could divide this with 100. I'll save the payload function. You can go back to the data. I'll send that one again and out 0.52. So it worked. I could divide it by 100. If I want to do something more, it might be that I want to have three temperature sensors. One way of doing it is that you use the bind function, and in that case, you can write like the if port is 1, decoded out byte 0, maybe you have port is 2, there is another temperature sensor, then decoded sensor 2, sensor 1, and I might have a different setting or whatever. I'll write like this, and I'll save that one. And let's see what happens. I'll go back to the data, and I'll manually do this now. I have S bind to 2. I'll send 52 on the port 2. You can see that sensor 2, it gives an output of 43, 0.43. Let's go and send something on port 1. So I'll S bind 1, and I'll write 20. And you can see that sensor 1, it gives an output of 0.5. So depending on which port, this is one way to do it. You could use different ports. Another way to do it is that you, in the payload, perhaps the first byte in the payload. So what you could do is if bytes 0, that's the first one, is equal to something. I think you need to write like this. Let's say that's equal to 0. Then you could write your own function after that one. It's different ways of doing the same thing. Let's say if I want to do more, I want a high resolution, I want to use not one byte but 2 bytes. And how much is 2 bytes? Well, if you know your binary and bytes, you from one, if I can send the same, I send 20, you can see that output here is 2 bytes. Which makes sense, as I said. Let's go back and look at the things networks console here. You can see here that the payload was 0014. Okay, now we need to think about what we're doing. Okay, this payload function, we'll remove that for now, because now we're sending 2 bytes. And depending on if you send it in little endian or big endian. If you haven't heard this before, it's just what's the most or least significant byte is. For when we're like counting just ordinary numbers as we humans count, I'm going to write 100, well, the first one, the 1 and then the zeros after, but the 1, that means it's 100. So, and then the other ones are in falling order, well, worth less. In computers, you can reverse it. It's called little endian, then the same number would be reversed. And it may sound confusing, but it actually depends on which system you run, and you need to know when you're sending bytes if you have the least significant byte in the left corner, in the left end, or in the right end. Well, you need just to be aware of it. So, and as long as you're aware of it, it's no problem. You can just try and your way forward, and I've written a little decode function here just to show you how I'll actually remove this one. It's just to show that it can be done in different ways. And I don't need to send any data. I can just play with the payload test function here. If you see now that I have a bitwise shift here, it's actually the same thing as if I take, in this case, the second byte and multiply that with 256. But this is just a way of shifting the bits 8 positions to the left, which is the same way of multiplying it. And let's say if I want to write, that's 1 byte and then 1 byte. This should fall out as 65,535. Well, it did. if the first byte is 00 and the second byte is FF, what happens then? Then, oh, it's still a very big number. So in this case, you can see that we have the most significant byte is in the end. So this is in the format of little endian. If I'm going to write it like this, 0 and 1, and test the function, you see that the output is 255. So just depending on how you encode it and decode it, just make sure that you use the right position and in which end when you take this out. So let's send something. I'll send number 20. Save this payload function first. I'll do it again. Out 20. Oh, great. And as you can see here, this is big endian. And sending this in unsigned short, that's 2 bytes. So let's play around. That means I should be able to send 65,000 and receive 65,000. Let's see. Okay, that worked well. Great. You can see the payload here. That's the hexadecimal, which means 65,000. And what happens if I get minus 10? Still 2 bytes, but this doesn't look right. Out comes 65,526. That's not at all what I was intending to send. So try to do like this. It still gives the same. This means that I need to take care about the data in some way here. And when I send an unsigned or signed, in this case it's an signed, which means that it should be starting from halfway. If you take this and divide this with 2, you get 32,768.